Now let us add few loggers to our application and see how Mule logs will be helpful to debug the Mule applications. If we are getting any kind of error or if we would like to check whether we have gone into a but onto a particular step in a flow or not. So for the log to implement the loggers, we will first review the information available under SRC main resources. There's a log4j module which is inbuilt available in MuleSoft applications. So once you create this Mule application from new window, Mule project, this inbuilt log4j file is already available there. Let us review this file and then we will see how we can utilize this information to print the loggers in the log file. So this is using the rolling file appender, which is the property of log4j. You can store your logs into the database or into a file wherever you would like to have. The file name here is the system properties dot mule dot home, then slash system properties file dot separator logs, and again file dot separator, then my first mule application dot log. So what does this information says? It says the mule home, which is where you have installed the MuleSoft server. Now go to the mule home, which is this folder. Then it is saying the slash logs folder, as I have already mentioned, and then it is showing you the slash the application name dot log. As you can see, this is already available since we had started this application in the last video. So let us try to put some loggers into the application so that we can see whether our application is running fine or not. Go to the Mule application once again. There's a logger component available in the Mule palette. We just have to type logger here and drag this logger component before the drop it before the set payload component. In the logger, you can type your own message. So, for example, I am happy that my Mule application is running. You can set the level of this log. It can be a debug, error, info, trace, or warn. Let us keep it as info. You can also have a category of the log, which is not mandatory. So we will leave it as it is. Then we'll save this information using Control S. And we'll try to run this application from here. So what we need to do is we might export this application to the apps folder once again, or we can run it as Mule application to start this application in the console, which is available, which is inbuilt in AnyPoint Studio. So right click on this and we'll try to use the inbuilt Mule platform. Go to Run As, click on Mule application. It will take few seconds to run this application. Okay, it's failed due to some problem. It might be failing because of the service is running there and the port is already occupied. So we just have to stop our existing running service and then start this application again.
it will take few seconds. Rep Let's wait for a few seconds to get it started and deploy the application. Yes, so we have completed the deployment. Now we will launch the browser and type in localhost :8081/hello. We can see this is the hello world, and now we can go to the inbuilt Mule console where we can see our logger message, which is I am happy that my Mule application is running. Great, so we have learned how to print the loggers in the console or how to print the loggers into the log file. I will show you how this logger will be printed in the log file also. So we will stop this application and deploy the same application to the to our standalone server, which will create the log file. Save and we'll have to delete the existing application from there. So in the apps folder, select the application and delete. Maybe the service is running. Okay, now exporting this my Mule first application under the apps folder and click on finish. It has been exported successfully in the apps folder. Okay, so now we will start this application from the services window. Click on start. Okay, server started, and now we will go to the same URL in the next in the browser window. Yeah, so it is showing the hello world. Now go to the logs folder, as I have already mentioned that we have keep this path to our log4j configuration. If we open the log file, go to the end, we can see this message is printing as the info message. If we would have selected the levels as error, then this info will get printed as error. Let us review our log4j XML once again and try to understand what all other information is saying. So we have already discussed about file name attribute. Now there is a file pattern attribute which is going to print the mule home slash logs slash my first mule application hyphen I dot log. It means that once a file is crossing the 10 MB of space, then it will create a backup of this file by appending -1, -2, -3, something like that, and it will keep at a max of 10 files of logs available in the log folder, in this folder. Let us see how we can create these loggers here. This part of this logger will be covered into the loops section of this course. So this is all about how we can create the loggers and how we can configure our log4j XML. We have seen both the ways how to print the logs in the inbuilt console of Endpoint Studio and how to print the logs in the file which is present under mulehome/logs folder with the name of the application. Thank you.